Right, well, I'm going to take these cotton wool balls and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put hot water on these as well, because they're cellulose, like the newspaper say. And now I've put 4 litres of hot water into that, and it's 1.5 litres of the pellets, so basically. And we'll see how it goes from there. It's still warm and it will take probably, probably another 2 to 3 hours to cool down, just by the feel of it, sort of thing. So I'm going to put these in here and add some hot water to it. Probably you only need enough to do one, but you never know. They might shrink down or something. So anyway, I think I put the jug on. I can't hear it boiling yet. Did I not press the button or something? I didn't press the button, so we're going to have to make a new clip or something. Anyway, so basically the newspaper cellulose on that will go on one, and these, once they've been wetted down and cooled down, will go on the other one, and I'll set them to float in another box sort of thing. So we'll see how that goes. So I've done another experiment today. I did some charcoal with some salt to see whether adding salt to your charcoal will actually increase like reduction of reductive flammable gas, which might explain the old adage with the rhubarb and things like that, and things like rhubarb, your not sauerkraut, what is the thing, you got asparagus, rhubarb, and the other thing that's very high in vitamin C that also likes sodic sort of soil sort of thing. Yeah, and they always say you can improve its growth by putting a heaped tablespoon in a standard watering can, or basically 10 litres of water sort of thing. So anyway, and no one seems to know how or why it works sort of thing, but maybe this is part of the answer. If we can actually get some more gas coming out of the charcoal, that might actually be the answer. But anyway, over and out for now.